Greetings yet again, everyone. This is Michael again. Welcome back to the channel here on YouTube. Well, everyone, Picard, episode number 2, Maps and Legends, premiered this past Thursday. And, of course, I watched it, everyone. I'm not trying to be the type that wants to judge the entire show by the premiere episode. So I'm going to follow the series. And one of my subscribers suggested that, you know, maybe you should do a reaction to each episode. I gave it a little bit of thought and I decided, yeah, that sounds interesting. Basically, this will be the first show that I've actually did that for. And that's what I did this last time. I decided to do that. What was that? What's going on? Oh, you mean this? Oh, well, this is just a flashcard, everyone. I watched the episode and I kind of scribbled down my thoughts and my observations so that, you know, when I made the video, I would remember what I wanted to talk about. So that's what this is, just my notes written on here. Now, I'm not going to give a plot or story breakdown because there's plenty of videos that do that so well and much better than I could. So I'm just going to give basically my first impressions, my reaction, my thoughts, and so on and so forth. But first, I'm going to take a drink of Old Glory because I feel like I'm going to need it. Ah, it's good stuff. Anyway, basically my notes followed the progression of the story, which, you know, makes sense as I'm watching, I'm writing. But some of it might be out of order. Now, one of the things about this show, and guys, I'm really trying to give the show an honest watch. I'm trying to get into this show. But one of the most annoying things, and the first thing that I wrote down on my flashcard here, is the fact that the language of this show, the way the humans speak, is so off target. It is so off-putting. And it just takes me out of the story. I feel like Star Trek Picard is filmed today. What with just better technology? I mean, these people talk nothing like the people we saw in The Next Generation. These people act nothing like an evolved human species that want to better themselves and have evolved above saying things like, "He's hot." Or saying things like, "You've got fucking nerves." This coming from one of the highest ranking members in Starfleet. I don't give a fuck how much she hates Picard. Bringing up the F word, that is so unprofessional. So un-Star Trek. I mean, I just feel like these new shows are just trying so hard to integrate in today's society and to attract an audience through petty dialogue, petty interactions with people that, you know, just bleed today. Do we really need all this profanity, all this crappy talk that mirrors today's world to bring fans in? I mean, you know, I'm all for language, everyone, but this is Star Trek. And I just feel like, you know, if I want to watch a show that has futuristic technology but takes place today, I can watch anything else. To me, Star Trek is just more important, and it's held to a higher regard than that. I need a ship, Admiral. Just a small ship with a small crew. Can you help me? What fucking hubris. When I heard that, I was just like, oh my God. Now we've got the fucking admirals cussing. So, you know, the language that they're using in the show, the words that they're using, I mean, let's just be honest. The further we go up, language is going to change. Yeah, we're going to use some of the words that we used in the past, but overall, language is going to change. I mean, you don't see us talking like they did in the Old West today. You don't see us talking like they did in the 20s. You don't see us talking like they did in the 50s. Language changes. And to have Star Trek grounded in today's lingo is just off-putting to me. It takes me out of the story. It makes me feel like I'm not watching a future. But anyway, that's my first reaction, everyone. The language. We saw a scene on Utopia Planitia that basically delved a little bit into the android betraying the humans and attacking the base. All fine and dandy, but you have humans on that station. I'm watching these human characters, and I feel like I'm watching a low-budget alien ripoff film with a crew trying so hard to be human. And even more than that, this group of people are making jokes, having fun, at the expense of the robotic characters, the androids. And I just found that really off-putting. I would like to think that, you know, even though they're not real, basic human compassion is that we don't laugh at them or make fun of them. I just found that very off-putting. I'm really starting to feel like the more this show goes, the less it feels like Star Trek. So I was a little bit annoyed by the human characters and the way they interacted with the androids. You know, it's almost to the point of, I don't blame the androids for attacking the Utopia Planitia. Look how you're treating them. So, we got that, and honestly, I don't even know why that was in the show. I don't know what purpose it served, but it was in there. My reaction, guys. Don't get mad. Well, I wrote this down again, the Admiral's cursing, so I guess that really kind of bothered me. Sheer fucking hubris, yeah. Now, once again, Patrick Stewart as Picard, definitely my draw to this show. Every scene he's in, I'm interested in it. It's fun watching him. I feel like, you know, that's my Picard. But at the same time, whenever there's something else on screen that doesn't involve Picard, I pretty much just feel like I'm watching a standard science fiction television show with nothing really special to offer. So Patrick Stewart is brilliant. I love him as Picard. The scene where they showed his old doctor coming back from the Stargazer, I love that interaction because we're learning about Picard. We're developing this character even further. He has frailties, you know, and I love that about Picard. But thus far, all the other characters are pretty standard fare. I don't have any attraction to any of the other characters. I don't have any characters that I really like other than Picard's housekeepers, the male and female Romulan. I do like those characters, but other than that, it's pretty, other characters are just there. You know, I kind of judge a really great Star Trek series by its timeless watchability. The original series has been out since the 60s, and I can still watch that show, get excited by it. I can tune it on anytime. The Next Generation, I can still watch that show, tune it on anytime, watch it. Deep Space Nine, the same. A little less, Voyager, even less on Enterprise. But great Star Trek shows are shows that have a quality that draws them to you, or draws you to them. They're just timeless. You just love them. But, you know, Discovery and Star Trek Picard, as it stands right now, and I know Picard's only two episodes, I really have no desire to return to these shows and watch them in the future. Okay, this is just a nitpick on my part, you know. I'm assuming that this show takes place in the prime timeline, Star Trek The Next Generation's timeline. So when Picard goes to Starfleet Command, looks up at the hologram Enterprises, why is the Kirk's Enterprise, why is it the Discovery Enterprise? For a moment, just for a moment, when I got a glimpse of the holograms, I knew it was going to be the original Enterprise from the television series, and I got a little bit emotional. And then I saw it, and I thought, what the fuck's going on? Is this show in the prime timeline? Maybe you fans can answer me. Is the show in the prime timeline, or is the show in an alternate reality, or is the Enterprise the same as the Klingons from Star Trek The Motion Picture? We're just supposed to assume that they have always been this way. The Enterprise with the different nacelle struts and all that that was in the hologram, is that just the fucking USS Enterprise and assumed to be Kirk's ship from the original series? And, you know, no questions asked. It's just supposed to be his ship. Is that what it is? It's frustrating. You know, for a minute, I just thought, well, they're going to give the fans a gem of a scene. Show the original girl in all her glory. And we couldn't get that. And, you know, one thing that turned me off before this series ever premiered was the Borg stuff. I mean, I feel like Star Trek has done the Borg to freaking death. There's a whole universe out there. There's a whole new world we can create. Whole new aliens. Whole new threats. Why does it have to be the freaking Borg? I didn't want to see the Borg. I didn't want to see the expansion of any Borg. I don't want to see the Borg. This Borg story to me is just totally boring. I don't care. I don't care about the Borg. I don't care about their cube. It's been done to death. Do something different. I don't want to see anything about the Borg. And this whole Borg cube that the Romulans have taken control over. We have so many different species working on this cube. I mean, we've got humans, we've got aliens that I don't even know what they are. We've got different species. We got all these species, and you mean to tell me that this thing has been kept secret from the Federation? It has not gotten back to any planet in the Federation. Starfleet is totally unaware. How the hell can that happen? I mean, let's say they're sworn to secrecy. Hey, if you work here, you're sworn to secrecy. Somebody would still open their mouth and tell. That whole storyline, I don't care. It doesn't make any sense to me. How the Romulans recruiting these people to work for them. How are they hiding this Borg cube? And instead of the Tal Shiar, we've got a group that is even more secretive than that. So we have the Romulan version of Section 31. And as far as I can tell from the storyline, their whole existence is to rid the universe of androids. They have this chip on their shoulder, this hard-on for androids. 2 episodes. I'll give them a chance, but it don't make any fucking sense to me. Okay. So, you know, seeing the Borg is not something just totally I'm just so excited about. I'm done with the Borg. I feel Voyager ruined the Borg. So there's nothing more exciting about the Borg at all. They gave a little bit more of an explanation of Data's cloning, that he had some kind of friendship with Maddox, and perhaps Maddox gained access to some of his positrons, and he used that in the cloning process to make these girls, which I still don't think makes any freaking sense. And I went back because I was a little bit unfamiliar with Maddox. I hadn't seen that. I hadn't seen the episode that he was featured in on The Next Generation in so long, so I had to go back and watch it. It was called Measure of a Man. I watched it a couple of nights ago on Netflix. Brilliant episode. Excellent episode. I got to give him credit. It was an excellent episode. Holds up great. In fact, The Next Generation television series holds up great. And, you know, people have made comments when they saw the Enterprise D in Star Trek Picard first episode, and they're like, man, the Enterprise D looks great. If it did look like it, never looked that good before. That's bullshit. The Enterprise D has had some brilliant shots in the remastering, and even the television show that equaled that shot to me. That's just me, guys, but I believe it did. But, and speaking of Enterprise D, when it was in the hologram form, why didn't it look different? I mean, Kirk's Enterprise looked different. Why did the D look the same? It just doesn't make any sense. And people want to say, well, you know, the first season, the Discovery went over budget, so they're using the same ships. You shouldn't have done that shit. That's stupid. Stupid. So we've got Picard's show taking place in the future of Discovery, yet Picard and crew are still using Discovery shuttles. Makes no sense. Okay, guys, I'm at the end of my notes. Sorry, I need a drink. I'm at the end of my notes. And the last thing I have on here is Starfleet infiltration. Starfleet has obviously been infiltrated by the Romulans. And I just find this such a tired storyline. I mean, it's so tired. And, you know, I just get the feeling that when I watch this show, I'm watching NCIS, Star Trek. I feel like there's nothing original in that storyline. Starfleet has been infiltrated by Romulans. Big deal. Who cares? I mean, who really cares? And what the hell is going on with Starfleet? They have become so laxed. They've got phaser fights, explosions going on near Starfleet headquarters, and they are totally unaware of it. I just don't get it. You mean to tell me you can go have a phaser fight with explosions that blew Picard 20 feet in the air and as old as he is, didn't do any damage? But anyway, as a side note, anyway, nobody is aware of this. Nobody's outside. Nobody sees it. Starfleet doesn't question anybody. There's no instrumentation that registers an explosion, weapons fire, nothing. We have no fucking security on Earth anymore. This show, I'm really getting tired of this stupidity in the writing. Yeah, they came back and erased everything that happened. But you mean to tell me, a renegade Romulan that works with Picard can discover what the hell happened, can see all these clues indicating what happened, and the fucking Starfleet can't do it? What the fuck happened to Starfleet? I'm really starting to dislike Starfleet in this show. So I don't know, guys. I don't know if this show is digging a deeper hole than it did when it started out. But honestly, the only good part of this series is Picard. I have a soft spot for him as a character. But all the rest of this shit, it's crap. They're writing it like crap. I mean, guys, dear Star Trek fans, I'm glad Picard is back. But I believe he deserves to be in a better show. Not a contemporary Star Trek show that has Star Trek in the name but takes place in today's world with advanced technology. Because that's what I feel like I'm watching. The dialogue is written like it's written just for we humans today. I mean, when you have an admiral dress down Picard and uses the F word while she's talking to him, I mean, I just gotta say, what the fuck? I mean, despite what you might feel about Jean-Luc Picard, the man's a legend. You don't talk to a legend like that because you didn't agree with something he did. I don't understand why most of the admirals in Starfleet have to be complete bitches. That goes for the men too. But I don't know, guys. You know, there were moments in this one that I liked. Basically, there were scenes with Patrick Stewart. When he mentioned Riker, Geordi, Worf, that was nice. When he had with a passion and said that, I don't want to risk their lives anymore, that was nice. But, you know, as a whole narrative, this is the kind of show that I feel like they're making it up as they go. And I don't know if they have a clear vision or if that vision, if it is clear, is really interesting enough to carry a show. I don't know, guys. I honestly, you know, I thought that maybe the second episode would build my faith into this show. But so far, it has done nothing to pique my interest or feel like this show is headed in the right direction. I find the subplots of the Borg cube, the Romulan spy on the cube, sleeping with Data's daughter and all that stuff, it just seems so unfitting. In a Star Trek series, the show just feels so contemporary that it doesn't feel like Star Trek. And I often wonder, let's say they made a sequel to The Next Generation, and it was so Next Generation that it actually looked like it, but a little bit in the future, but it looked like her. Characters actually talked Next Gen. It looks like human beings have evolved and became better. How would that show be received today? I would have to think that people would have liked it. But as it stands now, the more this show progresses, the less it feels like Star Trek. And I don't know. I'll keep watching. I'll keep giving my observations. If you like the show, that's fine and dandy. But these people don't seem like people that have bettered themselves. It doesn't feel like people that have evolved to positively influence the species. It doesn't feel like we're this exception to the rule. People don't seem special, really. We seem like fuck-ups more than anything. And I feel like the people behind the show don't understand what Star Trek is. I feel like all they know is that we've got to make a cool Star Trek. We got to add sex, cursing, violence. We've got to make this show appeal to today. Even if it breaks the very soul of what Star Trek is. I feel like oftentimes that the people behind Star Trek don't have the faith in what Star Trek is to make true Star Trek. Would the show be any less entertaining if it didn't have curse words? Would it be any less entertaining if the stories were cohesive and actually made sense? Would it be any less Star Trek if the people have evolved and decided to use their knowledge and everything that they are to better humanity? Where we feel like we're watching a show where we've risen above all these petty shit things today that keep humanity down. I feel like the core values of what makes Star Trek Star Trek are totally dismissive in this show, and that bothers me. It bothers me. But there you have it, everyone, my thoughts on Picard Episode 2, Maps and Legends. Take it with a grain of triple fur, but that's my observations, and it wouldn't do anyone any good if I lied about how I felt. This is how I feel about Star Trek right now. See you in episode number 3 in a week.